ಹಂಸಚಾಡೂರುಮರ್ದನಂ ದೇವಕಿ ಪರಮಾನಂದಂ ಕೃಷ್ಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗದ್ಗುರುಂ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬೈ ದಿ ಗ್ರೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ನವಗ್ರಹಾಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿ ಹಿಂದೂ ಧರ್ಮ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ದ ಡೆಸ್ಟಿನೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದರ್ ಗೇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದಿ ಗ್ರೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಮುರುಘಾ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಆಸ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಗಾಡ್ಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅವನ್ ಅರುಳಾಲ್ ಅವನ್ ತಾಳ್ ವಣಂಗಿ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರುಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಫ್ಯೂ statements about the necessity, importance and the efficacy of Navagraha Puja. Navagrahas are the 9 in number with the central control of the Lord Surya. Asatyena rajasa vartamano niveshayannamrtam martyancha. These are the Vedic words which emphasizes the vital power the Surya has in governing the entire universe. And Lord Surya provides us with food, energy, good thoughts, and whatever necessary to cultivate this human body as worthy of elevating itself to higher and higher realms of self-realization. And there are nine grahas, and these 9 grahas have got respective roles according to the astrology. If you look, they have special properties and special energies that releases, and the shastras and the Hori tradition, backed by the Vedic statements, affirm that if we propitiate all these 9 grahas appropriately, we would be getting the peace of mind, happiness, and above all, as human beings, we are always having some problem or other in our domestic, social, economic, and political lives. All these hindrances, all these problems would be warded off if we propitiate the respective grahas according to the horoscopic indications, which can be easily found out by an astrologer by referring to the chart, which we call Jatakam. Apart from that, the goal of human life is to realize oneself, which is called Atma Sakshatkara. And this is based on the basic principle that the entire cosmos is sustained by the basic substratum, which is termed as Brahman. And if we fail to utilize the rare opportunity of the human life to raise ourselves and go to different higher consciousness, we have not utilized the opportunity. And therefore, the shastras give injunctions that niyamam, pratyaharam, and all other constraints of good moral living would elevate us, would make us eligible to have the higher consciousness. And for all these things, there is a definite course of proper education. And in that scheme of things, the Navagrahas play a very vital role. And it is therefore necessary for us to understand the principles based on which the cosmic energy, which is controlled by the Navagrahas, are channeled and utilized for the welfare of the entire world. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu is the statement which is pregnant with meaning, and the Hindu Dharma strives, energizes, motivates and gives all the help and encouragement to the followers of Sanatana Dharma to ensure the universal peace and happiness. Therefore, worshipping the Navagrahas form the most necessary and vital initial step towards self-realization. The Surya is to be worshipped just before the dawn. Ushad Kala is the time that is between 4:30 and 6. At the time when the Surya comes in his chariot with Usha. Usha Devata is the most important medium through which we can address the Surya. Similarly, all the days are fixed in our astrological calculations. Each day is given, allotted to one graha. Shani, that is Saturn, in Shani, the day Saturday, and Shukra in Friday, and Buddha in the Buddha day, that is Wednesday, and Bhauma, that is the Bhauma is the earth, representing the earth, and that is that Lord is worshipped on Tuesday, and Monday they allotted to the sun. And Rahu Ketu are called shadow planets. They do not have the actual orbiting planets, but they are shadow planets. They have got effects according to the place in the horoscope those two grahas occupy. And therefore, propitiating all these grahas in their appropriate day is very efficient in efficacy. Because Saturn has an all-pervading effect, and it is stated normally Saturn is considered as a misnomer, as a planet which tries and gives us difficulties. But in fact, when we refer to the Shastras, Saturn is the vital regulatory energy which does not allow any negativity in the individual. In other words, he may be compared to a policeman who can regulate irrespective of whether a person who is in a high ranking position or in the low ranking position transgresses the rule. Whoever transgresses the rule, he gives the necessary punishment therefore. Therefore, Shani is to be propitiated with all reverence, because he instills in us the fear of God and the importance of morality and discipline. And therefore, Shani holds a key position in worshipping the Navagraha. Saturday morning is the best time for propitiating the Saturn. Another important thing is, in the science of symbolism, every aspect on the earth symbolizes some divine force, and in that context each graha has been allotted a particular dhanyam, and Shani is represented by the elle, that is sesam, and elle is considered to be also very mangalakaram, and it also earthly. If you can refer to the procedures of ceremonies, you will notice that yalli is being used in Pitrukarya, in propitiating the departed souls. And therefore, yalli represents the link between the living and the dead. Om Shanti 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 Uma Komala Hastabhyam Sambhavitaralatakam Hiranyakundalam Vande Kumaram Pushkarasrajam Harihi Om.
Thank you, Professor Sundaram.